Clean code is the gold standard of software practices, but what would be a well-structured code base without documenting complex algorithms, non-trivial decisions, or public APIs? A tangled web of letters, slowing progress and obscuring clarity. Fortunately, Jade Kane helps me. Proposal 467 proposes to embed the easy-to-use and learn Markdown syntax in JavaDoc comments to create maintainable and intuitive documentation for our Java APIs. Welcome, everyone, to the Inside Java Newscast, where we cover recent developments in the OpenJDK community. I'm Ana Maria Michalchanu, Java Developer Advocate at Oracle, and today's episode is about making Java API documentation easier to read and maintain, thanks to including Markdown in comments alongside HTML elements and JavaDoc tags. Ready? Then let's dive right in. There are a series of factors that continue to make Java attractive, like its platform independence, built-in security, ongoing language evolution, performance improvements, and a wide community of developers. And as developers, we rely on JavaDoc, Java's documentation component, to understand the purpose and functionality of classes, methods, and interfaces. Moreover, when we want to create stylized comments for our own code, we can use a combination of HTML and custom JavaDoc tags to mark up those and run JavaDoc command line tool to generate HTML pages from the documented Java source files. While HTML is a powerful standardized markup language, ideal for creating and structuring web pages, it equally uses a verbose syntax, requiring knowledge of various tags and attributes for different purposes. Because HTML is also tedious to write, many new developers prefer to use Markdown when creating README files, blog posts, and other types of content where plain text is sufficient. Hence, introducing Markdown in Java documentation comments would help us with having concise syntax for common constructs, reduce the dependence on HTML markup and JavaDoc tags, while keep enabling the use of specialized tags when not available in Markdown. This enhancement aims to simplify our developer experience when reading and writing comments in our source code, while preserving the capability to generate API documentation as before. So, how could we use Markdown syntax in JavaDoc comments? To signal the presence of Markdown in your documentation comments, each line should begin with three slashes instead of the current syntax. Besides simplicity and compatibility, the use of the three slashes for Markdown comments is in order not to change existing syntax of the Java language to allow new forms of comment. You can write Markdown documentation comments in the common mark variant of Markdown and choose to indicate a paragraph break using the blank line. Instances of block tags such as @since, @return, @c, @param remain unchanged except if the content of these tags is now also in Markdown. To further help with reading code documentation, you can choose to have extended forms of Markdown reference links as an alternative to instances of @link. For a simple link that has text derived from the identity of an element, simply enclose a reference to the element in square brackets. If you want to create a link with alternative text, just use the form in which the text and the element are each enclosed between square brackets. If you include fragments of source code in documentation comments with constructs like @code for short or one-line examples, you'll be happy to replace those with backticks. Similarly, for longer code examples, you can have fenced code blocks, meaning three consecutive backticks characters or tildes instead of pre-code or @snippet. In Markdown, the opening fence in a fence code block may be followed by an info string, which JavaScript libraries such as Prism can use to enable syntax highlighting. To benefit of syntax highlight in the generated documentation, you can add Prism JavaScript library by utilizing the javadoc --addscript option. So far, utilizing the three slashes in comments seems straightforward. So let's take a closer look to some syntactical details and more use cases. There can be horizontal white space at the beginning and end of each line of Markdown text, and that could change the meaning of some blocks. So, to figure out the content of a Markdown documentation comment, here's the scoop. Any leading white space and the three initial slash characters are removed from each line. Then, the lines are shifted left by getting rid of any extra spaces at their start. But we are careful to keep any spaces that are part of the text itself, as those might actually mean something, like starting a new code block. Another good news is that there is no restriction on the amount or type of characters that may appear after the first three slashes on each line of comment. For example, when the documentation comment contains code sample with their own comments. And speaking of code within documentation comments, avoid using JavaDoc tags within code spans or code blocks. In certain cases, to showcase mapping between concepts within your JavaDoc comments, you need to utilize tables. With the three slashes, you can now also define simple GitHub flavor Markdown pipe tables. There is one catch. Those tables should not contain captions or other features that may be required for accessibility. Documenting code is not just about placing comments above a class, method, or interface. Sometimes it involves sharing API design as well, like in the case of Java Collections API Design Frequently Asked Questions page. This document is included in JavaDoc, a separate HTML file at the level of top files directory inside Java util package. Similar to including HTML files in doc file subdirectories, you could add Markdown files to be processed accordingly. You can still use JavaDoc tags inside these standalone Markdown files, but be aware that YAML metadata is not yet supported. Some of the future work on having Markdown syntax in JavaDoc may involve detecting some stylized uses of headings and content and converting them in JavaDoc tags. For example, a heading of parameters followed by a list of parameter names and their descriptions could be converted into equivalent at param tags. Yet, there is more to explore in this direction. Some of us got used to declaring JavaDoc tags and probably would opt to have their concise form in Java documentation. And that's it for today on the Inside Java Newscast. Since you made it all the way to the end, please do me a favor and hit the like button, share this video with your colleagues, and let me know if Markdown in JavaDoc comments will make it easier for you to write and read documentation. Newscasts will keep coming every 2 weeks, and Nikolai will be back for the next one. Subscribe and ring the bell so you won't miss it.